Now, what are the characteristics of the absurd play, or how can we say that a particular play is an absurd drama or is an absurd play? Now, what we have in absurd play is there is an absence of conflict. Now, when we write a story or narrate a story or read a story, it has in its core a conflict, and all the struggle is directed towards solving that conflict. But what do we have actually in theater of absurd, or in plays which are absurd plays? They do not have this conflict. All the dramatic conflicts, clashes, personalities and power, all these things, they actually belong to a world where a rigid accepted hierarchy of values forms a permanent establishment. When you have a structure, when you have an establishment, when you have norms that you accept and follow which make sense to you, there would be a conflict. But when it comes to absurd, there is no establishment. There is no established meaning.
The absurd theater is a theater of situations as against the more conventional theater of sequential events. Now, there is the difference, like the traditional play or a traditional novel, we have sequential events where we have plot and the events take place through a particular sequence, and the dramatist follows the rules strictly. He is not supposed to change the sequence of the events. But that is no more the case with the absurd drama. There is no sequence of events. There are mere situations, and those situations can come and erupt at any particular point of time. There is no need to have a proper sequence of the situations in an absurd theater. And again, the example would be Waiting for Godot. Whether you read second act first or first act first, it makes hardly any difference, because there is not, the events are not in sequence, rather they are mere situations and the descriptions of some senseless objects or things in the play, which doesn't make a whole holistic structural narrative of the play. The Western theater of absurd highlighted man's fundamental bewilderment and confusion stemming from the fact that he had no answers to the questions like why we are alive, why we have to die, why there is injustice and suffering. These were some of the fundamental questions that West faced, and the philosophy of the West failed in fact to answer these questions. And therefore, we have plays which would not be dealing with these questions, which would rather be skipping such questions and dealing with narrative which is not in essence a story or a plot, or which doesn't actually develop a conflict or produce a solution to the problem. The theater of the absurd thus became an anti-literary movement in the postmodern times, where people found expressions in abstract painting, with its rejection of literary elements in pictures, or in the new novel in France, with its reliance on the description of objects and its rejection of empathy and anthropomorphism. Now, that was about the theater of the absurd and the characteristics of the plays which are written under the absurd movement, absurd theater movement. That is all we have for today at the World of Literature. Thank you for watching, and keep watching the world.